Господине Столтенберг, Македонија и формално е дел од Алијансата веќе неколку дена. Македонското знаме денеска се издигна и пред седиштето во Брисел, но секако членството во НАТО си носи и своји обврски. Што може земјава да очекува во периодот кој доаѓа?
North Macedonia is now member of the most successful and the strongest alliance in history, and the congratulations to North Macedonia for becoming a member of this alliance. And it's great to have you in the alliance because together we are stronger, we are safer than alone. And you are now a member of NATO, which means that you stand together with 29 other allies, based on the idea that an attack on one ally will trigger the response from the whole alliance. And by doing that, we preserve peace in Europe. We preserve stability, and that's good for North Macedonia, it's good for the Balkans, and it's good for all NATO allies. So welcome to NATO.
Изминатите неколку години најголемо внимание привлекуваат така наречените хибридни или сајбер закани. Што може НАТО да стори во врска со тоа и дали може да ја заштити Македонија од такви закани?
NATO has developed over the years strong capabilities to deal with what we call hybrid and cyber attacks. Hybrid attacks, these are these kind of attacks which are not normal military means of aggression. It's very often covert actions, disinformation, cyber attacks. And therefore we need to develop new tools to counter them. And that's exactly what NATO has done. We also have teams that can be deployed to countries to help them protect their cyber networks, to counter hybrid attacks, as we recently did to Montenegro, where we helped them to deal with different kinds of cyber threats and cyber attacks. So NATO do a lot to support allies, both when it comes to cyber attacks, but also hybrid attacks more in general.
НАТО исто така предупредува и за можно руско влијание на Балканот, вклучувајќи ја тука и Македонија. Дали очекувате таквото влијание да се зголеми, особено сега по пристапувањето на земјава во Алијансата?
Well, we have seen a pattern of Russian behavior over the last years with different efforts to intimidate neighbors, using military force against Georgia and the Ukraine, but also using cyber hybrid attacks against neighbors. I will not speculate whether this will increase, but what I will say is that by being part of NATO, you have the support of all NATO allies with our capabilities, our expertise, we share best practices, we have exercises together, and we share intelligence, information, and by doing that we also are able to counter all kinds of disinformation campaigns which are directed against NATO allies.
Светот во моментов се соочува и со кризата со коронавирусот. Каква може да биде улогата на Алијансата во тој поглед и дали може НАТО да помогне на земјите кои што имаат најголема потреба од тоа?
Well, this is a global health crisis and it's a common challenge which we have to face through common responses. NATO is not the first responder, but we can provide support and help to the civilian efforts to deal with this health crisis. And we see that NATO allies are doing that. The Czech Republic recently delivered protective suits to Italy and to Spain. Other NATO allies have provided different kinds of equipment. NATO have has provided airlift support. So we do a lot of things together. And by doing that, we are all more capable of dealing with this very serious health crisis.
За крај, македонските војници веќе и официјално се дел од Алијансата. Каква би била вашата порака до нив?
I met North Macedonian troops many places. I met them in Skopje and I've seen their professionalism, their dedication, but I've also seen them in NATO missions and operations. I met North Macedonian soldiers in Kabul in Afghanistan recently. I have seen how dedicated they are and how important the North Macedonian contribution to NATO missions and operations have been over actually many, many years. So by standing together, helping each other, we are all safer and more secure.
Господине Столтенберг, ви благодарам за овој интервју.
Thank you.